Well, beloved friends, welcome. It's 12:12 and time for Awareness Moments with Kira. And so delighted to be here once again and celebrate this now moment, this place where we live into awareness and allow it to celebrate itself in us. And what is it to come into awareness and say yes to living from this greater awareness? So welcome, Amy Hart Gobleski and E. Lopez Lockhart. So great to have you with me and others that will join us. Such a blessing to be here with you all. And as we come in together, hi, Elaine, welcome. As we're looking at what is it to be in awareness and how does it operate within us? How do we get out of the places we're stuck in the continual thought process of the mind and instead open ourselves to this, yes, moment and really be fully present in it? Hi, Mike Brentari. Hi, others that are involved in joining us here. In this time, we have a wonderful gift. In the slowing down of the outer world, we have a choice to begin to drift into our inner thoughts, to open to that place in us that is expanded in awareness, that is opening us to an inner realm that is always here for us. But in our busyness of mind and activity, we have a hard time remembering and allowing. We get so caught up in what we need to do next, what is important and what we think might be valuable and how I'm supposed to perceive. And we give a lot of power over to the activity of the mind. And so as I had an experience this week, I had several experiences, and I was going to share an example of this, which of course just has me laughing in bliss this morning, because one of the things that happens in the place of awareness is sometimes we really can't get to a thought. Now, a lot of this is out of dedication, meditation, a willingness to go in and quiet the mind. But sometimes after having many experiences of this, it's just releasing and drifting. Some people might get there through music or through art or through watching nature, just sitting. And I was laughing this morning with the squirrels and the birds in my backyard. And the squirrels are getting more and more curious. As I come and sit, they'll come up closer and closer and checking me out, I guess. And they have the funniest little looks on their faces when they look at me. And it makes me laugh with such great inner joy. And a part of what we're getting an opportunity to do is to let ourselves be so fully present in the moment that the thoughts drift away. They no longer dominate us. We are very dominated by our mind in this society. And we are learning what is it to not allow the mind to dominate and determine for us the truth of our being and how we are. So one of the experiences this week was I went into a no mind moment. Now, some of you know, or I'll say this here because maybe you don't. Hi, welcome, Christiana and Amber. Love you, my beloved niece, Amber. Glad you're on here. Is that years ago, I had an incredible experience of doing a lot of awakening work. And in the process of that, I was taken into a no-mind zone. In that no-mind zone, it's the only thing I knew to call it, the mind quit. There was no talk. There was no noise inside at all. Just total inner silence, inner peace, inner harmony. Everything becomes a part of you and you are part of everything. And I walked through the world absolutely just in awe and wonder and celebration of every experience. Welcome, Jeannie. Glad you're here with us. And Bobby, welcome. And so in that time period, when I'm in this no mind, absolute inner harmony, silence, complete silence, everything becomes an observation. You're just noticing what you're noticing. And life takes on, for me, my inner realization, and I really believe it's the truth of all of us, but mine is absolute joy, bliss. ecstasy of this experience of life, the experience, the exquisiteness of every experience. Now, some are, we are used to defining what's exquisite and what's based on what's positive. But what I experienced is every experience was exquisite. It was life experiencing itself. And so in this space, this inner space of there's only this freedom and this expansiveness and this joy that bubbled up. I think I laughed so much my cheeks hurt all the time because I was just in awe and wonder and joy. Or if I was in the deep inner space of, let's say something hurt my soul in that moment, it wasn't so easy to do that because I didn't have a story about anything. So I could, again, if there was pain that wanted to come out, it would come out so fast I could hardly get tears out. And in that experience, it was just experiencing what is in every moment. And so, you know, it's something that we have the ability to access, every single one of us, that place of exquisite awareness where the mind quiets. But we struggle with how to get there. Hello and welcome, Mike Cruz Zavala and Charlotte Hopkins. Great to have you with us. And in this journey, we're being invited during this time to maybe allow that drifting, allow that freedom within us. And if we can separate the mind from who I am, from the identity that I have, or the need to have any control over the experience in the moment, but just be it, just see it, just notice what the mind is doing and know I'm not that. That every now and then we may have the opportunity to slip into that space between those thoughts, to slip into that beautiful eye of the needle where we go into infinite awareness. And as we pass through into that, then suddenly it's just this exquisite wonder at everything that exists. So this week one day, I had been, I don't know, doing something that brought me joy. I said, oh, I want to watch this show that I've enjoyed a lot. It was based on Anne of Green Gables, Anne with an E. And I just love this little redhead. And I don't know, maybe because my mom's redhead, maybe she was a redhead, maybe because, I don't know, I've always had friends that are redheads. There's something about that unique, exquisite nature of redheads in my life that I just love this show. And it has all kinds of different experiences and things. But all of a sudden, I realized I was in this absolute no mind space and just in this experiencing in that moment. And I realized I couldn't get to a thought. Now, normally what I've found that if I need to, I can get to a thought when I'm in that space. But sometimes spirit has its own plan or the infinite is expressing through us in such a way. I could not get to, I was like, oh, there's a show I love. What's that show? I could not think of it. What station is it on? I even pulled up the TV to look at the little symbols and I couldn't for the life of me even figure out which one it was. And in the moment of that, I had the awareness that I'm in this no mind space. Well, I don't need a show. I can be in the drifting of the infinite creativity that is available to us from the inspiration, not what the mind feels I need to create in that moment, but allowing the inspiration of the universe to come through. And as I did, I just was in this. All I could do was just laugh and be in the joy and notice the trees swaying in the wind or notice even the breath in my own body and the wonder at life expressing. Now, during these times, we have a lot of opportunity to engage our minds and get even more active in the mental realm or engage our emotions and feel fear or feel, you know, we take it beyond empathy and compassion and we go into sympathy where we're feeling for the person, which really is not actually helpful for us or for them, because you cannot lift someone from the level at going down to where they are. We go to only honor and celebrate, but we hold them in the light from where we are. And the higher we are vibrating and willing to be in this expanded consciousness, expanded awareness, then from that perspective, we can love so completely, so fully. We can honor and celebrate exactly where someone is. We don't need it to change. We don't need it to be different. We don't need them to be different. So many things begin to come into a deeper balance in this infinite awareness. Now, my nature, I know that here I'm here to express this joy. And that joy is this a natural bubbling forth from me. And it is who I am when I am in my relaxed state. And I hadn't realized how much I'd taken on stress and tension and was, you know, showing up needing to make things happen and control the world, right? As if that's possible. And so what I want to invite is that what things help you drift away from the mind? To notice this week and begin to practice things that allow you to drift. If something engages the mind and gets you tied up in knots, it's probably not actually helpful to the level of awareness that is you're capable of expressing. It's one that keeps you stuck in a particular vibrational field or a particular reality. Or even question reality. I mean, it's okay to have all those experiences, but if you really want to come into that place, hi, Walter Soaring Eagle, welcome. And that when you really want to come into that place of expanded awareness, of simplifying this consciousness of oneness with all of creation, then find those things that take you away from the mind and into being, into that place where you're not thinking. I know friends that do things like draw mandalas or color them, and they've often said, well, is this a waste of time? But they've realized, no, this is the place where they find that calm, that peace, that resonance with life itself. Sitting in my yard with the birds and the squirrels and experiencing the beauty of nature as it sings its song through the leaves of the trees, or you know, the every moment of it, the sun coming through, is truly an experience of life affirming itself. So when we go in and open ourselves to say, I don't need to have, think this out and figure it out. I am just invited to relax into this now. I realized how much I had carried that tension and how I wasn't relaxing, even when I thought I was. And suddenly when we give ourselves that permission, that little by little, those knots of tension within our body, within our mind, within our being, begin to just drift away, fall away. We don't have to work at them or figure them out. We just allow the true nature of our being to rise and that awareness to begin to inform us. I hope that you have as much joy in your soul as I do when I go into the core of my being and I begin to laugh a whole lot more. Everything seems funny from the place of awareness because this is a game we play here upon this earth. And we take it all so seriously. Hi, Tony Corrigan. Great to see you, Reverend Tony. It is an honor and a privilege to be here at this time, to be in the ascension journey, to be opening to awareness and bringing that gift into the world. And the more we allow ourselves the freedom, the peace, the exquisite wonder of all of life expressing, even when it doesn't look like what we think it should, that's the time we get away from the thinking because it creates resistance in us and in this world. Oh, good. Welcome there, Walter. Oh, I saw you, and Ina, and anybody else I haven't mentioned yet, Domingo and Beverly, welcome. So glad to have you with us. So as you open yourself to this inner awareness, this inner possibility of divine play in this time of inner quiet, of shutting out some of the world. Let yourself shut it out. Let yourself release any sense of responsibility to it or for it, and just give yourself the blessing of being. In the moment of being, then amazing things can happen, and maybe you too will slip between the thoughts. open to awareness. So when that happened for me before, where it stayed and lingered for 14 months, that I lived from that place of absolute no mind. And in that, it was a truly remarkable experience. And I knew that that really is our nature that we're meant to come back to. Now, I got brought back and the mind came back in, crashing in, and I was a little disappointed, as you can imagine. And yet at that time, I knew that what was really occurring was I had more work to do to actually be free of those things that would keep me in bondage to the self. And so that's the work that we're up to. And so now what happens is I naturally slip into this place of awareness, or I live from it a lot of the time, but then the mind comes back in. And so what I know is if we are willing to do that practice of letting go, allowing, giving ourselves the freedom to be in that awareness, to be in the oneness with creation, to experience the exquisite magnificence of this world and all the ways that life expresses, then all of a sudden we too may go in and out of that place of awareness. Maybe it's for a second, maybe it's for longer. I've found that since that happened to me this week again, I am much more in that place, though I have moments that I'm not. So I'm recognizing, but they're extending. So what we know, even if it's at first a second, then it can expand and expand, and we can live from that place of infinite awareness. And yes, sometimes it so profoundly overtakes me, I can't get to a thought. How refreshing. And if I don't think it's frustrating, if I don't give it power to define something, then all of a sudden I allow. And in that allowing, whoo, the ecstasy and the joy just become a celebration of my soul. And I wish that for each and every one of us, to feel and know that profound celebration of the soul that comes from a sacred awareness. Welcome, Reverend Judy Grimes, glad to see you here. And each one of us get the opportunity to be in harmony with all of life. And that to me is part of the message of this time that we're in. How do I come into harmony in my own being, living from that sacred awareness in such a way that I now become in harmony with life? And that's what Earth is calling forth from us, right? The transitions that are happening as we stop and slow down and let life do what life does, then we are coming into a greater harmony with life. So as we go forward, we can come from a new place within ourselves, one that is harmonious within, and then creates a world in harmony that or sees the world for the truth that it already is. A harmonious, loving expression of creative, divine, luscious energy. Let us be in the lusciousness of that in our own being. Are you allowing yourself that space? Or do you feel that it supports the world by worrying more? Or trying to change it or make things happen before their time? Why don't you give yourself the gift of just allowing that luscious experience of being fully aware in the now? Let the mind do what it does. Notice it, let it drift, and you stay in the truth of your greatest, most magnificent awareness of being. I am honored to be with you all, and I wish you exquisite joy. I wish you freedom from within, and I wish you this awareness that delights your soul and that you experience the delight of all of creation. God bless you, friends. Have a fabulous, fabulous week.